Your first serious episodic run was with a show called Hawaiian Eye.
Right.
Got it written here, 156 episodes in 4 years.
Right.
At a grand total of $164.21 per week. How was young Robert Conrad's acting back then?
I don't know. It lasted 156 episodes. Someone was watching. By my standards, today, I look back and say I had a wonderful opportunity to learn to act. I must have had, we all must have had some kind of quality to have gotten the job in the first place. So I'm not going to be hard on myself. I think it entertained people. I still have people come up to me and tell me they watched the show. It was okay. My acting was, for a 22-year-old young man with no experience, it was like boxing. I was a novice. It was a novice performance, but I was in the ring. I was doing it.
Let's go back to Wild Wild West for a second. Who can forget that incredible show? Special Agent James West, duly appointed. Ross Martin, the late Ross Martin, your co-star in that show, was once quoted as saying, "I do all the acting, and Robert does all the stunts." A fair appraisal?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Of all the books that have been written, and there have been many, and some coming out now. Matter of fact, I just read one. I think it's a fair appraisal. Ross was a wonderful studied actor. He was a lawyer before he became an actor. He was an outstanding musician. He was in a show called Mr. Lucky where he played Andamo, wonderful character he created. Then he came into the show to do the disguises, the makeup, which I thought he did magnificently. And I became the athlete. And I don't know if they ever compared Ross to Barrymore. They probably could have. Because Russ was a magnificent actor, but I'll take the comparison to the other guy we just talked about.
Douglas Fairbanks.
I'll take Doug Fairbanks.
I'll
take that any day of the week.
You actually discussed with me before that you were a witness to him saying that. He was on The Tonight Show. You were watching.
Right. Well, I watched it. I like Russ. I liked him as a man and as a co-star. I respected him.
Right.
And when I knew he was going to do the show, because I liked him, I was a fan of his on set and off, I watched him.
Tuned in. Now, I read while you were doing Wild Wild West that you didn't believe you should have been getting so much money for it and that you gave most of it away.
No, I didn't give most of it away. I squandered a lot of it. I've never been motivated by money. I think I'm a man of higher principle. I made it and I spent it.
Now, was it my imagination? This is just personal for a second. Or did the fight scenes in Wild Wild West...
You mean this whole interview is impersonal?
That's right.
This is the personal question?
This is it. We're cutting to the quick here.
All right.
It seemed like the fight sequences in Wild Wild West were a little bit hyper speed. Unless you had 12 cups of coffee before you hit the set. But it seemed like when those fight sequences came on, you were really flying through midair.
Yeah, we were. And... what we were doing was choreographed, rehearsed with some of the finest stuntmen that have ever graced a movie set. And we had an ensemble company. The same stuntmen played the bad guys through all of the 102 or 104 episodes we did. I don't remember, two or four. And the audience, those that were diehard fans, knew that it was the same stuntmen. We'd take off a mustache, add a mustache, put in gray hair, put in a skull cap, so on and so forth. So they were real. I think they share in the success of the show as much as Ross Martin or myself or Mike Garrison, who's also with God in the clouds, I like to call it, who created the show. I think it was a lot of people making something that we're still talking about 25 years later.